Sairam children, today we are at the last topic of our chapter number 5, multiplication, which is mixed problems. Now children, what is mixed problem? In our last class, we have solved word problems, correct? So mixed problems are also the same. The only difference is that with multiplication, okay, we also may get addition or subtraction operation. Okay, we need to solve addition or subtraction also with the multiplication. That is mixed problems. Everything is given together. Okay, so first is we need to understand the question properly. Okay, and then we have to solve it. Like what we have to do, whether we have to multiply, whether we have to add, or whether we have to subtract. Okay, depends on the question. So let us see an example. Children, this example is from your textbook. Okay, now here, read the question loudly with me. Ritu had 3 packs of pens. There were 4 pens in each pack. She lost 3 pens. How many is she left with? Okay, so slowly, first you understand one by one sentence. Now what they have given in the question? Ki Ritu had 3 packs of pen. Can you see here? This is one, this is 2, and this is 3. Okay, there are 3 packs of pens. Okay, and each pack, okay, there are how many pens are there? 4. See, 1, 2, 3, and 4. See, each pack there are 4 pens. Okay, so this is given to us. Then she lost 3 pens. How many is she left with? Now to find out how many is she left with, first we have to find out how many total pens are there in this pack. Okay, so we can multiply, correct? What we will multiply? How many pens are there in each pack? There are 4 pens, correct? So it will be 4 multiplied by how many packs are there? 3. Okay, so 3, 4 into 3 is equal to 12. So how many total pens are there? There are 12 total pens. Okay, now this is the total number of pens. After that, what happened is she lost 3 pens. Total pen is 12. Out of 12 pens, she lost. Okay, so what we will do? We will subtract. We are going to subtract 12 minus 3. Correct? Because total pens are 12, out of which 3 pens she has lost. So we are going to take out 3 pens. What is 12 minus 3? Yes, it is 9. Okay, so this is our answer. How many is she left with? She is left with 9 pens. Understood, children? Now let us see what statements that they have given. Okay, now the first one is number of packs of pens. Okay, it is already given in the question. Okay, then number of pens in one pack is equal to 4. Now both the statements are given in the question. After that, number of pens in 3 packs, how we will find out? 4 into 3, which is equal to 12. Correct? So there are total 12 pens. Then what happened? Then Ritu lost pens. How many? 3. So she lost, Ritu lost 3 pens. So number of pens left with Ritu. Can you see the word left, children? Correct? It is a key word which will help us to understand ki it is an this subtraction. Okay, so the word left is important. So if we do 12 minus 3, we will get 9. Correct? So Ritu is left with 9 pens. Children, after this, take out your textbook and your notebook. Okay, so we know how to multiply, how to add, and how to subtract. Now let us see more this type of questions in exercise 5.6. Now children, before this we have done exercise 5.5, okay, and question number 6 we have not done. Now question number 6 is frame word problem in exercise 5.5, so we are going to leave the question, okay, no need of doing that type of question. Got it, children? So don't worry. So take out your notebooks. Question number 1. The given picture shows a stationery shop. Observe it carefully and answer the following questions. Now they have told us ki yes, this it is a stationery shop. You have to observe what is given in the picture. So let us see. Now we can see there are different items in the shop. What items do we have? We have pens, this one, then we have pencil, crayons, and then we have notebooks. Okay, now above that price is also given, okay, of each item the price is also given. Now children, this price is of one, okay, remember, it is very important. There are so many packs of pen is given. This is the price, rupees 55. It is not for all of them. It is the price of only one. Okay. Here so many pencils are given. The pack of one pencil is rupees 32. Here the pack of one crayon is rupees 65. Here one notebook is rupees 43. So by seeing, looking at the picture, we can say that what is the cost, okay, of each crayon or pens or pencil. Now after this, let us see what are the questions. Children, you are going to write this question number 1, okay, here this question number 1 you will write, and then you will write the A1. Now A1 is, Sheena buys 3 notebooks. How much does she pay for it? Okay, you are going to write A1. Note it down, children. Come on, write everyone. Now, Sheena, you can see, she bought 2 notebooks. Okay? Correct? What is the cost of one notebook, children? 43. Okay? But she wants 2 notebooks. So, we have to find the cost of 2 notebooks. How we can find out? By multiplication. Okay, we know the cost of one notebook is 43. It is given in the picture. Okay, so first statement will be, cost of one notebook is equal to rupees 43. Then the cost of 2 notebook, how we can find the cost of 2 notebook? By multiplication. Okay, what we will multiply? The cost, that is rupees 43 multiplied by 2. Then we will multiply. 43 into 2 is equal to 86. Correct? 2 3s are 6. 2 4s are 8. So Sheena pays rupees 86 in all. This is your first one. Understood everyone, children? Now B1. Write down the question also, children. Arnab buys 3 notebooks and 2 packs of pencils. How much does he pay for it? Okay, now Arnab, see here, what information is given? He wants to buy notebook and pack of pencils. There are 2 things, remember, 2 things are there. Now how many notebooks he want to buy? 3. Okay, and how many packs of pencils he wants to buy? 2. Okay, now here whatever is given, the rupees is given, it is only for 1. So first we have to find out what is the cost of 3 notebooks and what is the cost of 2 packs of pencils. Okay, then we have to find out how much does he pay for it. Okay, total cost we have to find out for the notebooks and for the packs of pencil. If we want to find the total pack, what we have to do? We have to add. Okay, so first we have to multiply and then addition. Let us see how. The first we are going to find out cost of 3 notebooks. How we will find out? See, cost of one notebook is equal to rupees 43. So cost of 3 notebooks will be rupees 43 multiplied by 3, correct? We are going to multiply it with 3. So when we multiply 43 into 3, we will get 129. Okay, so what is the cost of 3 notebooks? Rupees 129. Now after notebooks, he also wants to buy pack of pencils. But how many? 2 pack of pencils. Correct. So first we know that the cost of 1 pack of pencil is rupees 32. Correct. It is given to us. Now let us find the cost of 2 packs of pencils, which is equal to rupees 32 multiplied by 2. Correct. If I want to find out 2 packs of pencil, the cost of 2 packs of pencils, I have to multiply rupees 32 into 2. So 32 into 2 is 64. So what is the cost of 2 packs of pencil, children? Rupees 64. Okay. Now we know that the cost of 3 notebooks is equal to rupees 129, and also the cost of 2 packs of pencils is equal to rupees 64. Now we have to add, correct? Because he wants both. So total cost will be rupees 129 plus rupees 64. We will do the addition and we will get our answer. After adding 129 plus 64, we will get 193. So how much he needs to pay? He needs to pay rupees 193. Finally, we will write the answer. Arnab pays rupees 193 in all. Got it, children? Now children, see question. Okay, note down in your notebook. Soumya purchases 1 notebook, 3 packs of pens and 2 packs of pencils. Later she finds that she is not carrying enough money, so she returns 2 packs of pens. How much does she pay in all? Okay, so we have to find the total cost. Now what she wants to buy, let us see. Now she purchased 1 notebook. Okay, we know 1 notebook cost is rupees 43. Then 3 packs of pens. But children, see here. Later she finds that she is not carrying enough money, so she returns 2 packs of pencils. First she got 3 packs of pencil, then she gave 2 packs. Okay, so actually how many did she get or did she buy? Only 1 pack, correct? Because 3 minus 2 is equal to 1, correct? First she got 3 pack of pens, after that she gave it back. How many did she give? 2 packs of pens she gave. So how much actually did she buy? 1 pack of pens. Okay, then we know what is the cost of 1 pack of pen. Yes, rupees 55. The last one is 2 packs of pencils. Okay, now here 2 packs of pencils is given. The cost of 1 pack of pencil is rupees 32. If I want to find the cost of 2 packs of pencil, what I will do? I will multiply rupees 32 into 2, correct? And then I can find out what is the cost of 2 packs of pencils. Now children, let us do this with the statements. So children, our first statement will be cost of 1 notebook equal to rupees 43. Okay, then the cost of 1 pack of pens is equal to rupees 55. Now why 1 pack of pens? Because first she wanted to buy 3 packs of pen, correct? Then she returned 2 pack of pens. So how much is left? Only 1 pack of pens. So that we have to write. Cost of 1 pack of pens is equal to rupees 55. After that she wants to buy cost of 2 pack of pencils, correct? So what will be the first statement here? Cost of 1 pack of pencils is equal to rupees 33. If we know the cost of 1, we can find the cost of as many as we want, correct? So the cost of 2 pack of pencils is equal to rupees 32 into 2. If we multiply 32 into 2, we will get 64. 4, correct? So 32 into 2 is equal to rupees 64. After that, we have to add rupees 43 plus rupees 55 plus rupees 64 to find out the total cost or how much did she pay. So let us add 43 plus 55 plus 64. We will get 162. So Soumya paid rupees 162 in all. Okay. Next is question number 2. Honey purchased 4 kgs of mangoes costing rupees 35 per kg. Children, this slash which is given here in between, it means per, okay? 35 per kg. Per kg means it is the cost of 1, okay? Cost of 1 kg mangoes is equal to rupees 35, okay? These wordings are very important. When we see a 35, rupees 35 per kg, it means the cost of 1 kg mangoes. Then, she also purchased 2 boxes of strawberry costing rupees 65 per box. Okay, that slash means per. So, how much did she pay in all? Okay, so have you understood the question, children? First is, what is given to us? That she purchased, honey purchased 4 kg mangoes. Okay, they have not told us ki how much is 4 kg mangoes. They have only given us that 1 kg mangoes is equal to rupees 35. Okay, so we have to find out what is the cost of 4 kg mangoes. Correct? Then, she also purchased 2 boxes of strawberry. You all like strawberries, correct? So, how many boxes did she purchase? 2 boxes. Okay, 2 boxes of strawberry. The cost of 1 box of strawberry is given to us, which is rupees 65. Okay, so it is 65 per box. We have to find out what is the cost of 2 boxes of strawberry. So, we have to multiply rupees 65 multiplied by 2. And then, when we find out what is the cost of 4 kg mangoes and what is the cost of 2 boxes of strawberry, we have to add both of them. Because we have to find out how much did she pay in all. How much did she pay for the mangoes and also for the strawberries. Okay? So, let us find out. So, first we are going to find out what is the cost of 4 kg mangoes. For that, we need what is the cost of 1 kg mangoes. The cost of 1 kg mangoes is equal to rupees 35. It is given to us in the question. Okay. So, cost of 4 kg mangoes is equal to rupees 35 multiplied by 4. Okay. 35 into 4 is equal to 140. Okay, 4 5s are 20, 2 will be carry over, 0 we will write down. Then 4 3s are is 12 and 12 plus 2 is 14. So, the cost of 4 kg mangoes is equal to rupees 140. After that, we will find out the cost of 2 boxes of strawberry. Children, the cost of 1 box of strawberry is equal to rupees 65. Correct? It is given to us in the question. This one. Okay. One box, the cost of 1 box of strawberry is given to us. Then we have to find out the cost of 2 boxes of strawberry. How we will find out? By multiplication. By multiplying. Is equal to rupees 65 into 2. When we multiply 65 into 2, we will get 130. Right? 2 5s are is 10, 1 carry over, 0 down, 2 6 are 12, 12 plus 1 is 13. So, the cost of 2 boxes of strawberry is equal to rupees 130. Correct? So, we have got 2 boxes of strawberry is equal to rupees 130. Also, we know the cost of 4 kg mangoes is equal to rupees 140. So now we have to add both of them to find out the total cost. So total cost is equal to rupees 130 plus rupees 140, which is equal to rupees 270. Correct? If we add, come on, children, add everyone. 130 plus 140. 4 plus 3 is 7 and then 2. So, the total cost is rupees 270. Finally, we will write the answer. Honey paid rupees 270 in all. Okay? Note down everyone, children. Children, after this, time for homework. We have only one sum for homework, which is question number 3. Okay, read the question carefully from your textbook and write down the answer. Thank you, children. Have a good day. Bye-bye.